Good morning, South. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance with Ms. Henry.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
We'll hear more from her later in the show. Good morning once again, and welcome to the Falcon Report for this Friday, the 2nd of June, 2023, a day one. I'm Aiden Dombrowski.
And I'm Ibrahim Kadri. Last Thursday, it seemed like someone left the blender running for 6 years as the Senior Remix shook things up. With the scoop, we turn to the Falcon Report's Sophia Noguera.
I'm here at the Senior Remix, where things are really mixing up.
Thursday evening, seniors regrouped with their elementary school peers in an epic rehashing of their 7th grade mixer. Meeting in classrooms before the night's festivities began, the elementary alumni met together to develop their game plans and exciting entrances into the gym while wearing customized t-shirts. When the time came, each elementary school burst through the gym doors in full routine with semi-synchronized dance and chant. The night kicked off with the jump rope relay. Forest Road took an early lead with a victory in this event. Other events included the Floor is Lava, where competitors had to transport their entire team to the opposite side of the gym only using designated sports equipment and without touching the floor. The Outer Streamers took the win on this one, leading into an intense match of crab soccer where a record number of points was scored against Brooklyn Avenue. The tug-of-war event proved a test of strength and strategy for all teams, with William L. Buck coming out on top. Sportsmanship surged the gym, with non-competing team members even rushing to the floor to support their peers. After a boisterous display of team chants and cheers, the night's victor was eventually decided, Forest Road.
If we wasn't doing it, who else was going to do it?
Exactly.
Like, who was going to do it? Comment W, Forest Road. You already know who's going to come on top. Like, come on.
All in all, the event provided seniors a chance to reminisce, mixing in some healthy competition and camaraderie.
For the Falcon Report, I'm Sophia Noguera. Go, go, Monero!
Following the electric senior high concert, junior high students followed in their footsteps with two show-stopping performances. Miss Elizabeth Klampkin led the combined 7th and 8th grade orchestra, performing the recognizable theme Ein Klein Nacht music, followed with hit songs from Lady Gaga, ending the orchestra section in great applause. Mrs. Melanie Bedell's 8th grade band was next, starting with Lutopia and, of course, Never Gonna Give You Up. To end the 8th grade portion was Mr. Kyle Hayden's chorus with accompanist Dr. Tom Zatorski. They then hit the risers with La Musica and an all-around classic, Viva La Vida. South Hall was not empty for music for long as the 7th grade concert followed a few weeks later. Miss Melanie Bedell returned, hitting the stage with Breakout and Happy. Finishing off the junior high musical showcase was Mr. Hayden's 7th grade chorus, performing Oye La Musica and Reflections of a Lad at Sea. With the performance ending, students, conductors, and parents went home in musical satisfaction.
This past Friday, South's 7th, 8th, and 9th graders were given the chance to participate in the highly anticipated Field Day. Making their way onto the field, the first event of the day was the Dizzy Bat Relay, where students were tasked with spinning around on the bat and running in one direction. Then, there was the Over-Under Relay, where a sponge was passed down a line and had to squeeze as much water as possible into a bucket. Afterward, they competed against each other in an intense game of Steal the Bacon. The fourth event of the day was a game of tug of war, and the final game was a water balloon toss, the intent of the game being to make sure that it does not break in order to win. Once the fun-filled day came to an end, all students were given ice pops as a tasty treat before departing.
With a legendary career spanning over a decade and a half with South High School, our very own principal, Ms. Maureen Henry, recently announced her retirement.
The Falcon Report's Emily Notterb had the opportunity to sit down with her to reminisce and discuss her legacy at South.
Emily?
I'm joined now with our principal, Ms. Henry. So, in your 16 years at South, are there any specific memories or traditions that you consider your favorites?
Absolutely. In my time, we started the Service Week and the Family Service Day. We started Unity Week, uniting neighbors, individuals together year-round, and all the activities that we've done to support the life skills students, the Challenger Basketball, the Center Stage, and the times that we've really rallied to support a student or faculty member in need.
And what type of legacy do you think you're leaving here at South?
I think the legacy that I leave here is the importance of kindness. You know, I was not the one who made up the school motto of small acts of kindness make a big difference, but I think that I've put a lot of energy into supporting that and maintaining that. And I also think that my legacy is also that academics come first, that no matter what you do, you have to value your education. We push every student here to be their very best, whether it be an honors class, just even getting that 65 in their class. We've put in a lot of new advanced placement classes here. So I'd hope that my legacy will be the importance of academics and the importance of kindness.
And what plans do you have for your retirement?
Oh, I intend to sleep late, not have to get up in the morning. But no, really, I am going to continue and teach a little bit more at St. John's University. I want to get in a book club, and I want to travel the world.
What message do you have for the South community?
My message is never forget how important kindness is. No one ever forgets a kindness. Never forget the importance of being your best and striving to whatever your dream is. Work with your teachers. They're very caring here. They go above and beyond every single day. Just always have fun and continue to make South the best school in the district as it has always been. And I still think it's going to be the best school everywhere.
Clearly a career well spent. Back to you in the studio.
When the Falcon Report returns, we'll talk much more about this Monday's Memorial Day Parade. But first, a bird's eye view of outdoor physical education classes. The Falcon Report will be right back.
You've seen everything from the worst, Bad Cinderella, to the best, Hamilton. But you haven't seen the greatest yet. Come to Shakespeare Society's Much Ado About Nothing in the Courtyard today and tomorrow at 7 o'clock p.m. We hope you enjoy the show.
In commemoration of the lives of service members lost in military conflict, Valley Stream honors Memorial Day every year with a sprawling parade and memorial service. The Falcon Report's Isabella Dombrowski was on the scene.
That's right, I'm here at Valley Stream's annual Memorial Day celebration.
This year was no exception to the dazzling display. As part of the parade, South's Marching Falcons, under the direction of Mr. Daniel Cregan, graced the community with a spirited performance. With their first steps on Rockaway Boulevard, the band marched long parade route while trumpeting military service airs and patriotic tunes. Joining the ranks of more than five other marching bands from Valley Stream community, the Marching Falcons marched alongside town officials, student groups, community organizations, first responders, and more. The parade, concluding at the Henry Waldinger Memorial Library, preceded the solemn memorial service held to honor fallen Valley Stream residents where the marching band performed the national anthem.
For the Falcon Report, I'm Isabella Dombrowski.
Hopefully this weekend's forecast will bring more sun and warmth to get us into that summer feeling.
Okay, don't get ahead of yourself. We still have an entire week left of school. With the weekend outlook, we'll throw it to Jonathan Matthews.
Jonathan?
Well, guys, today will definitely be warm, but I can't say the same for the rest of the weekend. Today we'll see sunny skies and temperatures climbing to the low 80s. Tomorrow, however, will bring high chance of precipitation with a nearly 20-degree drop in temperature. Sunday will continue the coolness, hosting partly cloudy skies. Temperatures will seem to warm up at the start of the week for a spectacular summer send-off. Try to make best of the forecast ahead, South. Back to you in the studio.
Did you hear Mr. Corsentino mention the track team on the morning announcements last week?
I did, and quite a mention they deserve, taking home county honors to end their season. With the details, we turn to Alina Trzynski one final time.
Alina?
Thanks, guys. The track season ended for most at the county championship. And a great end it was. Sophomore Rachel Griffith placed a close third in the 400-meter hurdles. Melissa Gay dominated the 100-meter high hurdles, earning herself a comfortable spot at the state qualifier. Senior Tori Daniels dominated the 200 meters, winning first place overall. On the boys' side, senior captain Jason Gutierrez broke the school record for the 400-meter dash, breaking 50 seconds as well. Also in sports this week, seven seniors participated in a signing ceremony in the gym this past Wednesday. Athletic director Mr. John Koskowitz joined parents, administrators, and coaches in celebrating the signing of their letters of intent. A great future is in store for the departing Falcons. And that's sports.
That's all for this final regular edition of the Falcon Report. For Ibrahim Kadri, I'm Aiden Dombrowski.
Have a great weekend, South.
So Ibrahim, what's next for us?
College.
Hold your horses. We got to finish school. We got to go to the graduation practice. We got to go to the breakfast. We got pre-prom practice. We got to set up for this.